Boys and girls, welcome back. Tone King here, coming at you live from the Tone Lounge. This is interesting because this is not my normal camera. Because I had to use an old camera because I want to show you the new camera, okay? So in this video, I am going to wrap up. I know there was a couple of previous videos on my journey in finding the right upgraded camera equipment. And it's all done. And I wanted to share that with you. I wanted to let you know where I was and where I've landed, okay? So for the last 3 years, this is the camera I was using. This here is the, this is a Canon. It has a wide angle lens. This is the XA20. It's a hard disk based recorder. It's very durable, you know, really well built. It has one of these little spin around things. So if you're recording yourself, 60 gig hard drive, extended battery, microphone input. This is what I've used for the last 3 years. It came to me at NAMM, came to me at concerts. I took pictures with this great camera, and it's still not going away. It's not going anywhere. It's a great camera. Okay. But I was itching to buy something new, and you all know if you subscribe and follow my videos, you'll know that I bought the Panasonic, and I wound up returning the Panasonic, and all that stuff. So this is where I've landed. This is the latest and greatest in the edition. This is my new camera, and this one here is the Canon XA20. See it right over here? XA20. So this is my new, this is my treat to myself. I always buy myself guitars and pedals and all that stuff. And the truth is, I felt like I deserved an upgrade. You know, I have about 1,000 videos online. I love my YouTube channel. I love when everybody tunes in, the comments, the feedback. It's rewarding. And you all make it rewarding. And this is my treat to myself. And the good news is you get to benefit because now you get to watch videos made with this camera right here. So this is brand new. I'm still getting to learn how to use it. So I've gone from this right here to the XA20. Now here's the interesting thing. The XA20 is actually not that much bigger than what I've had. But there's some nice addition, okay? By the way, the reason why this, the camera that I'm using, there's no wide angle. Today, all the cameras have wide angles. In fact, I had to buy this lens on here, on my XA20, I had to buy the wide angle lens. This camera has a wider angle lens than the camera, than my XA20, the XA20. Now, what is, if in case you don't know, wide angle is like right now you see me, but when you have a wide angle, you could see more. Boys and girls, welcome back. Tone King here, coming at you live from the Tone Lounge. I'm actually using two cameras right now, and the camera over here is the my Canon XA20, and the camera over here is my my new XA20. Basically they're set up identical. They both have autofocus set up. They both have they're set as P. The auto white balance is set as it should be. And really what I want to do right now is just look at the difference quality wise between both cameras. So that's the goal of this video. Thank you for watching and rock on. Later. So I've used this camera two times already. I will include those two links in the description. So if you want to see two videos with the XA20, and of course all the videos going forward will be the XA20. I'm still getting to learn how to use it. It's a powerful camera. And let me just tell you why I got this. I'll walk through the feature set real quick. So first and foremost, it has a handle. And when I'm at NAMM and when I'm, you know, walking around, this is a lot more secure than this, which is what I used to do. Okay? I used to do this, you know, hold it, and now I have this. Number two, you could tell it's got true XLR inputs, which is a really nice feature. If you're doing interviews, it's nice to have an XLR input. Now, I know with something like this, I could have gotten an XLR adapter to a 3.5 millimeter, blah, 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 blah. But you know what? You read the reviews and it's not always compatible. People say this static and this hum and this hiss. And you know what? I didn't want to deal with any of that. You know, sometimes when you have one shot to get, you know, the perfect moment, it's nice to have something dependable. And that camera has been dependable, but I never did all the add-on crap. And that's what I like about this. The add-on stuff is built in, okay? I have my two XLR inputs. I have a hot shoe, so if I wanted to add something on top... As a matter of fact, we're going to talk about the audio. There is something I'm going to add on top of here. You have, if you're holding it like this, you have the start, stop, and then the zoom in, zoom out, so you could do it all with your thumb if you're holding it. Or if you're doing this, you also have the rocker switch, so you could rock, you could go zoom in, zoom out here, or if you're doing it like that, you could zoom in, zoom out here. So no matter how you're holding it, you could operate the camera, which is nice. Okay. Not only does this have two XLR, so it could do mono, it could do stereo, but another thing, so if you think about, let's talk about audio for a second. What are the different audio applications you may need? For me, and these are questions you should ask yourself if you're serious about, you know, your interests, your hobbies. If you're into video, maybe you'll learn something, so check it out. For me, I need to interview someone. So I always wanted a proper XLR. It's also nice if, like when I did the Schecter, the Helwin amplifier release at NAMM, I was over here, I didn't have a shotgun mic, and they were over there. So I can mount, it gives you this little clip over here. I could basically mount a shotgun mic over here. See that? I don't have a shotgun mic, but I could mount a shotgun mic up here. So I could have one XLR jack for a proper microphone, so we could I could interview you. I could have a second XLR for my shotgun. You with me? And then when I'm doing something like recording a band or something like that, I pick this bad boy up. Hang on. And this is the cherry on top. This is like peanut butter and jelly over here. I picked up the Zoom H4N. This is like, they say it's second to none audio quality. And you have a little adapter, okay, and a line out. And basically you take this, you put it on the hot shoe, like that, And now you have your stereo. You never have phase issues just because of the way it's properly lined up. 90 degree or 180 degree angle, true stereo. And you could take this and go into your 3.5 millimeter jack, which for me, in one pass, it covers all of my audio needs. Microphone, shotgun, and stereo imaging. And of course, this was the only add-on right here. And that would sit right on top just like that. Okay? And if you Google H4N, that's what this is, you'll see a lot of people attach the H4N on their camcorders and their DSLR because it's good audio. And the audio, the built-in audio on all camcorders is so-so, menza-menza, okay? What else? So you have, of course, a mic input, HDMI, USB, headphone, you need all that stuff. There's a remote switch, so if you want to, you know, if you have this up on a boom and you want to control it remotely, you could do that. You have manual focus ring, so if you want to do DSLR type functions, you have a nice big pop-out screen, okay, which is touch sensitive, like an iPhone. Dual SD cards. Now check this out. Like as an example, when I go to NAMM, I always recorded in HD, and then I went to the hotel at night and I had to render it down because I didn't have a lot of upload speed. Which, by the way, everybody always asks the question, you know, dude, it's like 2013, why is it not in HD? Because when you're in a hotel and you don't have bandwidth, the videos won't go live as quickly as they do if they're not HD. But check this out. Since there's two SD cards, at the same time, I could record HD and non-HD. Think about this. And if it's non-HD, the videos will go on even faster. How's that? I'll give you one of those. So I could record HD and then do non-HD at the same time, you know, one pass recording, which is awesome. It also does, check this out, infrared. See that over here? Right there. So when you're backstage and it is lights out, there's a little infrared like lamp over here, and you could see in complete darkness. Okay. Of course, it has this. It comes with this nice lens protector, the hot shoe. If you can't have this open, you could close that. This comes out, and you could do one of those bad boys right there. Okay. So this is the king of camcorders. Now, if you watch my old videos, you'll remember that if I'm shooting, when I say shooting, you know, taking pictures of a band while they're playing, remember the rule, no video. You're not allowed to videotape the band. So I not only bought this, but I still have my Canon T5i, okay? So I treated myself. I got the T5i for still photography, and then I got this for my video. The beautiful thing, in case I have a problem, this does video and this does still. So I have complete redundancy in my setup. And not only that, but they're both Canon. So like the menus are kind of sort of the same. You know, of course there's subtle differences because one is a video camera, one is a camera. But the look and feel from a learning curve perspective is that much less. So this is my new rig. I treated myself, okay? Now, with that said, there are a couple of things that I still have in my back pocket at all times. One of them is my Zoom Q3, Q2, and Q3 HD. I'll show you those just so we have a complete video. Here is my, this is the Q2. These actually record really good audio. They're cheap enough where if someone's helping you out, you could give them a camera, you say hit the red button, and just record whatever you can, and this gives you a lot of B-roll footage, okay? So you have a Q2, and then you have the older Q3. You would think Q3 is newer. It's not. It's the older version, which I happen to like better. This is the Q3. So if you have your chance to own a couple of these are good because they record in HD. The audio is spectacular. They're simple to use. It's like hit the red button, and you just hand them out. So when you're working with people, like when I'm at NAMM, I'm like, Paulster, here's one. You know, Double D was at the skin thing. I said, here's one. You hand them out, and next thing you know, when the night's over, they give it back, and you just got all this footage just because they were hitting the red button. So that's awesome. So I have these in addition to, you know, these are kind of my handouts. This is really now official backup camera. And then of course I have my XA20 and my T5i. So that is the official Tone King rig. And of course, the one camera that I'm using is a very inexpensive Canon Vixia HFR10. And that's probably along these lines, except you have an optical zoom. The audio is not so good, but there is a mic input so you could do an interview. And of course, there's no wide angle, which sucks. So there, that's it. That is the dealio. And I'll actually share, I'll give you one cherry on top. Everybody's GoPro, GoPro, GoPro. I get it. To be honest, I spent my money on real, kind of like real expensive stuff. You know, this isn't cheap stuff, and hopefully it shows my commitment to putting out a good video, because the reality is I want to make a good video. You know, a long time ago, let's walk down memory lane for a second. A long time ago, I used to get dinged all the time. People would say, dude, what are you doing? Your audio sucks. And you know what? I don't get those comments anymore, because I spent a lot of time trying to figure out the proper way to record audio. And let me tell you something, it's not easy. I'm passionate about this stuff. I love this stuff. So this is not only my treat to myself, but it's my giving back to you all, because I want to make a better video for you all. Okay, this is the cherry on top. I don't have a GoPro because they're freaking expensive, but I do have a MUVI, M-U-V-I. If you haven't seen these, check these out. These are little, handheld, ultra wide angle little cameras. Of course, this comes with like 10 different ways. You could connect it here, you could connect it on your, hang it off your ears, your bicycle, your car. Same thing as a GoPro. The difference is, this is $120, something like that. Now, of course, is the GoPro better? Maybe, I don't know, but this works. This is records in full HD. I believe it's 60p. Maybe I'm wrong, I don't know. But let me turn it on and I'll show you real quick. Oh, hold on. I hit the wrong button. So you basically just flick, it has mini USB, it has HDMI, and you know, it gives you a nice little, you know, you could see, well, actually, look at the wide angle, so check that out. You could see the whole area behind. Let me move my hand. See that? Isn't that awesome? So there you go. You could see this has a nice wide angle. Check it out. This is the MUVI, M-U-V-I. It's actually made in England, I believe. So that's the, and of course, this type of thing will be in my pocket next to my cell phone, or maybe I'll hook it on something so you don't miss those special moments. Anyway, that is the video of the day. And that's it. That's a wrap. That is what I own. Everybody always says, what do you do and what kind of equipment do you use? That's it. That's the equipment I will be using going forward. And last but not least, I might as well, just to, for the sake of completeness, audio-wise, some people say, what do you use for audio? I use the Eminence Tone Center, which is behind me. I mic it up with a blue Encore microphone that goes into an Alesis MultiMix. The MultiMix goes into Sonar. And then Sonar, is, of course, runs on my PC. And the way I sync my audio and my video is very simple. When I hit the record on the camera, I hit the record in Sonar, and I go like that, and it gives me a very crisp, sharp, sound. And then I sync my audio and my video with one of these cheap little things, okay, which you could buy on eBay for $6. That's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave your comments below. Let me know if you like it. Let me know if you thought it was informative. But that's a wrap. That's where we're at. Thank you for watching. Subscribe, comment, like, share, all that good stuff. I'll leave you all off one of those. And until next time, rock on. Later.